Welcome back to Living 808. Now, we all know that it's illegal to drive under the influence. Most people understand that this means alcohol. But did you also know that driving under the influence includes the use of marijuana? Now, we are learning more about that today. We welcome in Officer Thomas Billens, Lieutenant Patricia Wilson, Kevin Sabet, who is the co-founder of Smart Approaches to Marijuana. And we've got two parents with us today, Jolene Morris and Myla Ravad. Hello. Thank you all for being here.
Thank you.
Now, I'm kind of excited today because we're going to do something fun. It's a serious subject, but we're going to actually play a game. I'm going to be the moderator asking the questions. We've got three experts here, and then we've got our parents, and you guys are going to be answering the questions. How does that sound?
Okay.
Okay. All right. Let's jump right in. Our first question. Let's see. Well, medical marijuana dispensaries can actually open any time now. In fact, we'll probably see them open by the end of the year. Under the law, patients with medical marijuana registration cards are allowed to have 4 ounces of usable marijuana. Now, let's look at this here. Which of these do you think is equal to 1 ounce of marijuana?
This one.
Okay, so you're Jolene, right?
Yeah.
Jolene, okay, so Jolene, you say this one, what about you?
I think so too.
Okay, who's our expert? Officer.
Yes, actually the 1 ounce would be this one here.
Oh, wow, that's a lot.
So we see a lot of confusion. You know, 1 ounce of marijuana is actually a very large amount of marijuana that people can use. And right here we have a baggie that would be approximately 56 joints. So this is about what somebody could actually have under the law.
Wow.
It's a lot.
Are you surprised by that?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, because like you, I'm a parent too. I would have gone for the smallest bag,
right?
But 1 ounce, and they're allowed to have 4 ounces.
Yes, so technically 4 of these bags.
Okay, all right. Interesting. Okay, question number two. Which of these, let's see, we're looking at trade number two, which of these can be used to ingest marijuana? So Myla, why don't we start with you?
Well, this one for sure. But I think this stuff too.
Okay, what about you, Jolene?
Ingest it, like eat it?
Yeah, use it.
Oh, can this one?
Mm-hmm.
That one? Okay. This one I think most people recognize,
yeah.
Right? But Lieutenant, can you give us the correct answer?
Okay, well actually all of them can be used to ingest marijuana. So there's different ways of ingestion, and it includes smoking and also vaporizing, and that's inhalation itself. And so the smoking with the joints right here, or also with the bong, and even with this particular device here, it's a matter of burning the marijuana, and then that gets ingested. With these particular devices here, the e-cigs, and also they're called vaporizers. And that, the element right in here gets heated to a certain temperature, and then the active ingredient gets inhaled. And the scary thing about them is you never even realize that someone can put a marijuana extract in there. And even something as small as one dab can have a THC level as high as 90%. So it's frightening, especially for someone who's never tried it before, and this is the first time they're trying it.
And the THC levels of regular joints are, this is probably at 10% or less. The 10% would even be high. You're talking about being able to put 90-some percent, and there's no smell, right?
Exactly, and that's another thing, too, is they're very popular, the e-cigs and the vaporizers, is because there's very little odor. Whereas when you smoke a joint or even through a bong, you have that really pungent odor of marijuana. And if you've never smelled it before, once you smell it, you can't miss it.
Okay, that is so interesting. And I noticed that we chose parents here.
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
even for me, I mean, some of these things we've never seen before. So if you see them in your teenager's room or something, at least you would know what it is. So really, the goal today is to get educated, right? Okay, question number three. Let's see here. I'm glad I'm the moderator answering the questions. Question number three, marijuana edibles are not legal in Hawaii yet, but it is a concern in the states that have legalized them. Now, one reason is because people aren't always aware of the serving sizes and the amount of marijuana in them. So parents, can you look at this tray number three? Can you point out which items on this tray do you think has marijuana in them?
I think maybe the lollipop and this.
Okay. How about you, Myla?
Well, yeah, the lollipop, that too. And is that like a gummy bear?
I don't know what that is. But it looks like candy, yeah, right? Everything here looks like candy.
But you can soak it in gummy bears. So. Mm-hmm.
Who's our expert for
well,
this
Well, you know, the interesting thing is it's kind of a trick question because it's true that, you know, the yellow and then actually the corner, they don't have marijuana in them, and these three items do. And this is actually a chewable, like a Tootsie Roll that you just punch out of there. But it's sort of a trick question because any of them could actually have it and you don't know it. They look exactly the same. There are plenty of edibles in states that have even medical marijuana, not just recreational, that look like that. And that's the scary part is it's lying around the house and your kid, you don't even know which one has mm-hmm. marijuana and which one doesn't. It's not a joint, which a lot of parents are used to, mm-hmm. you know, seeing.
Yeah. Okay, that totally scares me because I did not realize that lollipop has marijuana in it.
Absolutely.
We're almost out of time, but I'm sure that some of our viewers are saying, oh, they're overreacting about marijuana. Yeah. Alcohol, you know, we've seen research shows that impaired driving, you know, that can cause accidents and death. What do you say to those parents?
Well, the science is very clear. Look, there's an active industry that wants to, just like the tobacco industry, downplay the negative effects because they're making money. I mean, they're selling gummy bears to kids. You get lifelong customers, just like, you know, the Marlboro Man and the, you know, candy cigarettes we used to have. So the issue is, though, that the science says that the THC, which is what gets you high in marijuana, it affects directly the part of the brain that deals with reaction, reflexes, judgment. And so, actually, marijuana, the best research says it at least doubles the risk of a car crash. Some research says even more than that. When you combine it with alcohol, which is usually what happens, it's not someone's choosing one or the other, use both, it's even worse than driving alcohol alone, you know, drunk driving alone. It's a huge concern. In Colorado, they've seen a massive increase in fatal car crashes where recent marijuana use was the culprit.
Okay, very, very scary, but it's something that we have to educate ourselves
with
and talk about. Thank you all very, very much. Whew, okay, driving under the influence. It includes prescription drugs, alcohol, and marijuana.
Absolutely.
We are going to have much more on Living 808 when we come back. Stay with us.